Earlier this week, we introduced you to the movement to shut down the website called Pornhub. Well, the big news today is that Visa and MasterCard announced that they would no longer process payments for the porn site. Well, that's a good first step, but it's not nearly enough to really get rid of the hardcore and violent imagery on the site that caters to pedophiles and other sickos and depictions of violence against women, the sexualization of our young people. Now, the fact is, if you didn't know this, Pornhub is a massive enterprise. It draws in millions of viewers every single day, and nearly 7 million videos are posted on the site every single year. It's going to take a massive effort, all of us, left and right, coming together to really make a dent against this depraved porn behemoth. And now a petition from the group Knockout Abuse West demanded that Pornhub remove videos depicting strangulation, choking, plastic bag suffocation, women being hit, brutalized, and tortured, women looking younger than 18 in videos in the teenage category, verbal abuse, humiliation, and degradation, and sexual torture and rape. My next guest provided some of the source material that the New York Times used in its recent report on this. Joining me now is Dr. Gail Dines, president of Culture Reframed, author of Pornland, How Porn Has Hijacked Our Sexuality. She's done incredible work over the years on this issue. Dr. Dines, now, in response to all this scrutiny, Pornhub says it's taken steps to address the child porn issue on its site. But you're basically saying we should not believe them. Why?
Well, just before the show started, I actually went on Pornhub to see, look at the categories, to see if they've taken any down. And for example, there was thousands of videos with the word stepdaughter in them, or stepson, or stepbrother. And this is where basically they hide those videos they used to call incest videos. Also, they had on teen porn and then young-looking porn. So it's all just a smokescreen. It's all just a basic PR job to say that they're going to change things. Because the truth is, what you just described in pornography about the violence, if they take all of those things down that Knockout Abuse wants them to, there'd be nothing left on the website. It would be completely empty. Because pornography is based on violence against women and on the dehumanization and degradation of women and children. That's what pornography is.
And there are winks and nods, Gail, throughout the not only the Pornhub website, but in their marketing of Pornhub to pedophiles, those who would commit acts of violence, sexual violence against children. And they try to blow this all off. Oh, you're being prudish. This is real. This is all in good fun. But I think most Americans hear this, they want to throw up. They can't believe that this is allowed, and they can't believe that major corporations had allowed payments to be made on their systems for videos on this website.
Well, I don't know if it's the truth is so many American men are using pornography and are using Pornhub that they actually know what's out there. So I think it would be less of a shock than you're actually saying it would be. And also, just one important thing, it's not so much just attracting pedophiles. New research is coming out that shows that men who are using pornography with adult women actually get desensitized and develop a sexual interest in children through boredom and desensitization when they wouldn't have had a sexual interest in children had they not got into porn. So this is even worse, because what we're doing is expanding the amount of men who are potential predators of children. And I myself interviewed 8 men in prison, all of whom were in for downloading child porn, all of whom had raped a child. Not one of them was a pedophile. And when I said to them, they were all porn addicts, by the way. And when I said to them, if you're not a pedophile, why did you rape a child? You know what they said? We got bored. We wanted something else. So they got bored. And this is what male privilege is about. They get bored, so they destroy lives.
It is, I mean, it takes your breath away. And you thank you for pointing out that distinction, Gail. And late night comics have kind of, you know, laughed a lot of this off and the way they've discussed this issue. I think it's important that we play sort of how this has become a big joke to some of them. Watch.
Yeah.
Pornhub offered free snow removal during the blizzard yesterday to people in Boston and New Jersey. They cleared your sidewalk, your driveway, and your browser history.
the coronavirus may cause millions of people around the world to have to self-quarantine at home. Response, Pornhub said, we are ready.
Pornhub has been raising money for good causes. They use your porn searches to get you involved in a cause, which is genius.
Genius. Gail.
Well, you know, porn is often the punchline in a joke. But let me tell you that feminists have never seen pornography as a joke. We were the first group to say that this is causing harm against women, that basically it reinforces women's subjugation as a sex class, and that what it does is cement patriarchal ideology in men's minds. We have never thought this is a joke, and we are the ones who laid the groundwork for all of this. And now, when I look back at what got me into this and how I started being an activist against porn, I'm actually, in a bizarre way, nostalgic for the images of Playboy and Penthouse, because it is literally unbelievable what you can now access for free within 5 seconds on Pornhub.
Dr. Dines, we have to go, but we're not letting go of this issue. Thank you so much for being here tonight. And-